Welcome to Summoner's Rift. Seconds until minions spawn.
We got big first kill right there.
Absolute, just smashing.
Yeah,
we're doing so good.
I was actually gonna say that, and then I had to turn on the commentator and make sure we were blue. That sometimes I get kind of confused.
Callback joke.
Yeah, I get really confused.
Yeah, we are blue. There's Dexter, and it seems like they're about to kite buff.
Can't hear us? Shit, there's a lot of delay.
Okay.
Awesome.
Way too loud. Wow, I just hit the mic. Yeah. I don't think we're going to be hitting the mic too much.
I mean, I might. That should be a little better. I talk really loud.
Got some trading going on in mid lane between the Singe and the Fizz. Fizz looks like a really cool skin.
Oh yeah, I like that. Trident Lady's cool.
That's a man.
What?
Yeah, I know, it's crazy.
League gets confusing.
Oh no, that's Pyrrha. I was about to say that was a lot like Aatrox.
This clip's gonna come for 20 years.
Yeah. You're gonna go to your 9-to-5 job and then just fire you because you couldn't tell that Fizz was a guy.
I'm gonna walk through my my complete 9-to-5 job. Middle of the workday, I'm gonna call him to the office and be like, yeah, we have some leaked Discord calls.
Yeah.
From when you were 15.
Anyway, it seems that we have Tarik and Wildling. I actually play Tarik. Tarik is a really fun character with a lot of utility. But actually, they're going in.
Big kill right here.
Oh, maybe if they can get to the Tarik, but it looks like they're not. Yeah. Dang.
Well, he should have died there. He should have walked into
it. He used his flash though, which tells bot lane that in case they go for another play in the time limit, they can go for it without worrying about flash. He is a support. Oh, they're really misfortune.
I get the misfortune there.
They got really close. That was a pretty good trade.
It's a good push for the bot.
Nice. We got swing. Oh,
big kill.
They brought that, what was it, misfortune out of the tower. That was pretty sweet.
And that was a, we had our, isn't it our jungler?
Jungler
came in.
Pantheon got that kill. Looking really nice for the
really big push right there.
Yeah. I know Dexter was getting pretty low there earlier.
So it looks like we're leading on experience, money, and kills.
Yeah. Looks like Hunter's going after that red buff. I mean, the new patch with jungle pets. I don't know, I'm not a jungler. It's actually really interesting with the new patch.
Are pets cool?
Pets are really cool.
Do they help you in some way?
Yeah, they do. They give you a little bit of money and they fight monsters beside you. It's really interesting.
There's a little fight going on there.
Yeah. A bit of poking, a bit of trading. Yeah.
Since she's a trident, or he has a trident.
Yeah.
It's
utilizing that trident.
No.
Oh, it looks like there's a gank. Yeah, they're ganking top lane. See if Zane can pull through. Zane is a go on board. That's pretty good.
Next semester, Zane will not be playing top lane.
Next semester?
Yeah.
Really? What is he gonna play?
He's going to be commentator. He's going to play league.
Killing spree.
So Zane figures there, but.
Be so for real. Really?
Yeah.
How do I not know this? I'm from the team.
I know. It's absolutely insane. I thought you already know. So
he's commentating next year or next semester. Who else? That's crazy.
No, I mean, as all the other fans have been, I'm actually the but in general, Zane has more astute knowledge than he will bring in.
He's very well educated. Oh, it looks like that Mundo just popped out of the bush. Let's see if Mason can
Come on.
Yes!
Nice.
That's
nice.
Big right there. That's really big. So is Connor playing a character that can transform?
I think no, it's his pet. Pretty sure his pet is allowing him to do that. I'm not that educated on the patch. I'm putting two and two together. That's a chameleon.
How new is the new patch?
I'd say it's about like it came out last month. I think it was when did we come back from break? I think it was right before. You know what? Somewhere in that area. Just like a few weeks ago.
Somewhere in that general area.
Yeah.
So it happened a little while back. So there's been plenty of time for both teams to adjust to this.
Nice. Kill. Our sweet Dexter. Looks like they're going after the Mundo.
11 kills here, so we're definitely leading on experience, huh?
Yeah. It's looking good.
Little Rift Herald bug. And
that's
dragon.
The
dragon's there. Nobody's going after it.
Well, you gotta time it. You gotta time it right.
Well, all of our guys just passed. Like, two or three of our guys just passed dragon. It's kind of insane. I'm expecting to put a, what's it called? Things that you see there. A warp on it.
A ward.
A ward.
Yeah, you were so close. You were one letter off.
So close.
Yeah.
I expected to put a ward on it to know when the other team's trying to push it. But I guess we're just going to let the Earth Dragon sit there for a minute.
Let's see. It looks like Panth doesn't have a control ward, which is probably like the better idea, like better ward to put in there. So if our Panth Maddox hits that ward, it's probably a better idea to put that in. It looks like they're about to like, take the turret.
Yeah. I don't play
like
League, so they might have some huge big brain strategy. I don't know.
Well, right now the big brain strategy is to not die in the first
turret. That's
yeah.
Very big.
Yeah, Mason got a couple hits under that turret.
Ooh.
That fake out from Mason? Looking good.
He absolutely juked her. Broke her ankles.
Yeah. Kind of crazy. That was actually so satisfying to see. Lure him into the bush.
He's gonna go on a clip montage.
Looks like they're going after Dragon now.
Finally.
Yeah.
Dragon after a part.
Dragon's your favorite part.
I was really sitting there like, when are they gonna get Dragon?
They have. First Dragon under the belt. Who gets it?
9 plus armor.
Magic resistance, which is gonna do so good against Tarot.
Yeah, aren't there, doesn't two of their people use magic? Like,
well,
that one? And
yeah, Fizz does do a good amount of magic damage. I'd say like Fizz, Tarot are probably the best.
Oh, they're dudes. Pushing mid.
Which, you know, mid is usually the one that gets the most towers down because of how it's located on that. Looks like Garen came down from bot to try to join in with whatever happening.
Our jungler. Let's see if the pet leveled up.
Yeah. Oh, you're right. The chameleon turned into a platypus.
It's standing now.
Well, look at the tail. It's like a platypus, almost. Fizz is running away. The tower's down. Looks like Mason's making his way to the river. Looks like he's kind of... Oh, he goes back mid. A funny ult made by that Tarot. I'd say that Tarot's ult is better made for like team fights when things are starting to look south. But hold that ult like middle of lane. Interesting.
And that 9% advantage in armor is actually gonna be really big. Especially magic. So that's magic. That's
looking nice.
Shut down.
Shut. Oh. Swain's down. But that turret shot really, turret's gone. But with those turret shots, they were able to get those kills despite the fact. Casual trading on bot for top lane.
Team's turret has been destroyed.
Looks like Connor just managed to scrape his way out of that fight with that, what was it, Garen?
I believe so.
Tough.
What's
up?
That red light above Connor?
The red light above Connor?
Yeah, for a second there was like a flash of red light.
Good question. I wasn't paying enough attention to give you that answer.
Maybe he ran into like a word or something that follows him? I don't know. It was really interesting.
Words don't do that, but it might have been like an infected. It looks like they're going. going after the Taric now. A good target to pick off. He uses his ult, so he's gonna move a little bit. Chase him down.
Yeah. That's a dub right there.
That's a dub, but your Mason is like, I think you're gonna do the math. 11 minus 8.
11 minus 8.
Okay, what's 10 minus 8?
It's 13. 11 minus 8.
It's 13.
Yes.
11 minus 8 is 13. How can you go higher?
Oh, three.
There you go.
I think three
levels ahead from the Taric. How do you get that from 11?
I will not answer that question.
Garen pulling out that spinning.
Our jungler soloing the dragon.
I know you like the jungler's little dragon moves.
He's my favorite.
Yeah.
When really, the only thing I ever play is bot lane. So, oh, look, we got another buff. Let me check that out.
Hexic Dragon.
Interesting.
Ability Haste. Stack, nice. Looks like they're going after Herald.
So, those faster swings, that extra armor, they're just gonna win.
I mean, 20 to 6? Pretty correct.
No. And this is the semifinals for
first
state.
Yeah, yeah, first game of semifinals.
There's only there we go, there it is. That thing.
Yeah, that's a word. That won't follow him. Oh, that?
Yes.
Oh, that's, hold on. It starts with an O. That, you use that to find the wards.
Oh.
I'm gonna say,
looks like they're trying, looks like everybody's supposed to be a team fight here.
Yeah, it's really, it's, minus our top.
Oh, a whole big team fight.
Yeah. This Fortune's out.
And
looks like Pantheon's out.
This is a bad,
Connor
this is
beats
a bad
the Mundo. And it looks like Mason goes after that Fizz, going after that Taric, and that's a triple kill from Mason.
Nice.
Taric getting that.
And with the whole team death, we can now, except for the top laners, they're still battling out. But...
yeah, that's usually how it goes. They're just doing their thing up there. That's why they have teleport, so they can just hop in whenever they think it's destroyed. Their jobs are to just like farm up there. And so once they come in, they're like units. Going after that inhibitor. It looks like they're retreating now, overstaying a little. Mason. Going down bot instead of going down mid with everyone else. Looks like he's trying to farm a bit down there. Connor taking his camps closer to the enemy camps.
Little dragon guy is looking kind of nice.
Our dragon guy? Oh, his little pet?
Yeah.
He is. I'm going to have to ask him to explain to me what exactly his pet is.
Yeah, because I think I've seen a healer. It's healing him. It's doing damage to him.
Yep. I mean, that definitely could be.
I guess
looks
only
like
the
it.
Jungler.
I mean, I wouldn't say necessarily. Like,
no, I mean, like, why doesn't anybody have that?
So I think that's a part of your, maybe. Or no, maybe it's a summoner spell. Yeah, I think it's your summoner spell. Junglers, you try.
Godlike.
The jungler
we're team
usually
pushing
has
their base.
Yeah, we're definitely pushing down their base. Interesting thing about junglers that they have their own fun little summoner spell. Summoner spells are these two little icons next to each player icon. Those used to, yeah, that used to be smart. And that would allow for the jungler to quickly take the other team's dragon or baron or just the camp. And so with the new primal smite, which is where the pets come from, that sort of replaces. So it's actually really interesting the direction that League has taken with the new patch. Looks like we're retreating from base, overstayed a little.
will overstay our welcome.
Yeah.
Everybody's buying items.
Yeah.
Wait, we're a jungler? Just jungling?
Just jungling, yeah. Let's see. Is he? Where is he? There he is. Looks like he was gonna go after the drag for a second. That is my foot. Mason going down mid. Looks like the river isn't warded yet, which, I mean, it doesn't seem like they're utilizing river too much. I haven't seen that much ganks this game. It looks like with that ping, they're gonna try to go after the turret. Put up that's an enemy ward right over there.
Right in plain sight.
Yeah. Which, I mean, a lot of those...
Seems like the game's over. I think I heard them.
Yeah. I mean, we still have, like, those 5 minutes of
shut down.
To watch. Looks like they're trying... let's see. Our mid laner and our bot ADC teamed up. Where's our... Mandion is back at base. Oh, that's interesting. He's going straight from his fort, taking that turret shot in the looks like where his guys was.
A big turret?
Yeah. It looks like their priority right now is just to get that KDA up. Turret goes completely untouched.
We got the fire dragon,
right? Oh, yeah, we did. That was probably one of the honorable facilities. Goes for last bot turret, going after Viking to be the inhibitor. Yeah.
Now is it possible to go ahead and just destroy their last bot?
You gotta go after the first two turrets in front of the Nexus first. But yeah, you can totally like let the inhibitors just stay there, or the first round of turrets. Looks like Terra killed off that ult, which definitely like saved that window. I think without that ult, Lina would have been gone. Garen pulling out his spin move, Misfortune and her ult. Looks like they're all pulling it out. Let's see, looks like Panth is going down the turret. Looks like he's realized that he's just by himself, making it back towards our jungle. They're definitely showing their aggression up in their face. I'd say, personally, like, if we were just in a casual game, just practicing, this would be the point where FF would be initiated. Well, who knows, you know? I've seen professional league tournaments. Of course, it's not rare, or it's pretty rare. An FF, yeah. It's happened before. Surprisingly, they weren't, like, in that spirit. Looks like our Panther's going after that turret. We go on the other side of the wall. A Swain and, Singed in base. Looks like they're going up after that middle inhibitor, which seemed to have respawned. I got those, the casters, all the minions going after those turrets, and it looks like, we're pretty much, like, ending this game. Inhibitor just, makes it to where their enemy wall isn't, passed out. Like, you can...
So you can't watch it?
Yeah. So, if you destroy those inhibitors, it looks like that's a win on the tally mark for the Itakuras.
right to fear my greatness.
Draven out.
I do not tolerate cowardice.
Brian's deep.
Fear is the first of many foes.
Thank you.
looks like we're in our second round. It looks like Maddox actually went Swain this time, which is definitely interesting. Dexter going Jhin. That's a fun combo. Swain is usually Dexter's main.
That is interesting. You think they got picked out and they had to pick somebody else? I think he's just switching for fun.
I think he's switching for fun. 30 seconds into the Tri-Bush on bot lane, looking to make an engage.
What are they doing?
They
want to party?
Pretty much. What they'll do is they'll travel in a pack at the beginning of the game, and that's when they invade.
The oath.
It looks like no one's really picking up on that invade yet, but yeah. This round, we are red team. We're the ones with the red HP bars. It's really interesting. Looks like a ward was placed on bot lane. And then
you lack imagination.
Hand of Callista down in bot lane, ready at their turret. Oi. Malphite's ready at top lane. Brayden Perkins. What is he playing this round? That looks like Olaf. That's good for Olaf. I haven't seen that yet.
Now, is Olaf a snowman?
No, Olaf is actually, he's a mini. I forgot what he is, actually. That's Olaf, right down there. That looks to be like a Blood Moon skin. But okay. Olaf.
Frozen.
Yeah. No, I see the connections.
Yeah. Some people forget that his name is Olaf.
Yeah, I suppose so. I haven't seen Frozen in a while. Oh, it looks like some aggression. It's like that Callista just flashed away. I suppose that Pantheon was a counter pick. So that Maddox wouldn't get that Pantheon, but I'm not paying attention. I'm not sure if Pantheon locked in before Maddox, but I know Swain was definitely on there. It was definitely one of the team decisions. Let's see. Mason's waiting in the bush. Real close, waiting for that gank. So we got mid lanes all open for that, what is that? Gangplank. Ooh, looks like Mason got the first blood. Our Swain Maddox is staying down along with Jhin. I believe that's that Blood Moon Jhin. Looks like Blood Moon Jhin. I don't think that's a Blood Moon skin. I'm not familiar with Olaf, but
is Blood Moon a set of skins?
Yeah, Blood Moon is a set of skins. Personally, I think it's the coolest set of skins.
Is Zane playing Gangplank?
Zane is playing Malphite, yeah. Oh god, he's pretty goaded on Malphite. See, I have no idea if that's the skin that PlayVS gives you. That's a pretty sick Malphite skin. Looks like Connor's making his way through his camps.
We're a little behind on money this game. How will that affect the rest of the game?
Oh, right now I wouldn't worry about it. You know, our team's gonna do whatever does best and win this.
Let's win.
Yeah.
It's getting it though.
Yeah, I think there's three bot side mid is really gravitating towards bot for a lot of the beginning of this game. Gangplank's just, you know, bombing mid, puts that barrel over there. I'm not sure why. Mason's coming back mid. Away from that barrel. Let's see, down here, we have our Jhin and Swain, back up the bot lane, looks like Swain hits hit there. getting half of his HP hit by that, what was that? You. I believe that was a Cardinal that they're talking about. Botley's really pushing this one. And still going. Swain flashes away. With.
Do you like Nidus?
Yeah.
That looks like Kratos.
Kratos.
Yes.
From.
God of War.
God of War, yeah. That's sick.
It does. Not, I mean, not like exactly. Look at him. He just reminds me of Kratos.
I've actually never played God of War. I've only heard things about it. Ooh, Easton coming in with my ghost. Graves being. Nice to. Ooh. There. No worries. It seems that Connor pulls up the Oculus looking for everything. Honestly, no idea if Oculus is the right word. The red thing that comes up? The one you had a question about?
Maybe it's like Orbit?
It's like Or something.
Or. I'm called the
Orb. Or. The Orb.
Yeah.
The Orb. Ah!
Oh, we had the money lead.
We had the money lead.
We had the money lead.
We had. Oh, yeah.
We still do. Mm-hmm. We have money lead and kill.
I was so wrong. It's Oracle, not Oculus. It's Oracle. Looks like Botley really clutches it there. They were getting really low on health, but they managed to take out the whole Botley, and that was really interesting. It's always fun to see what plays they make. Looks like they're going after Dragon. Corbin,
my favorite.
Your favorite. They're going after.
What dragon is that?
That's the Water Dragon. Push back there. Oh, he hits him with that slow. Speeds it back up, whips him back. He's trying to go after that turret to try to negate them with some turret shots. That's real interesting.
Seems like we're doing some interesting stuff going along the river.
Yeah, it looks like he uses a health potion. Those look like health potion effects. Oh, it looks like they popped the Herald on him. Gets rid of it real quick. Jin down here. It seems like Bot is nice and warded. Swain's coming in, taking out that blue team.
Two. Three.
Interesting items.
Definitely interesting. It looks like they're camping in a tribush. Looks like Mid's going back. A really interesting technique is to stay in that tribush. Kind of to kind of pop out because it's closer to the blue side.
So you can get do a little peek-a-boo.
So you can do a little peek-a-boo.
Killing spree.
So 3% health every second for the dragon buff that just got.
Yeah, the ocean dragon.
Nice.
Great, yeah.
And the boogers are actually doing really well. That'll really help me in big team fights.
Ooh.
Or when they push some base.
Yeah.
When they push some base at the end, the 3% health for 5 seconds is really good.
Yeah. It looks like that Graves took Hunter there. Mason on a 1v2. Let's see if he can get away. He popped his ghost and he runs off. That's probably the only thing he could do. See James Swain down here. Who's with him? Looks like we have some bottom damage. Managed to pick up James Swain, which makes him just like a real human for a while. Looks like they're camping over the tower, trying to evade some of those attacks. Quite a bit of defense. Jin goes after it, and they get three kill. Double kill, Jin. Good job, Dexter.
Let's go, Inactivers.
Let's go!
Woo!
Connor went after that scuttle, grabbed some stuff.
And it is the fan. Chat says, are we gonna win? Yes. Yes, we are.
We're definitely making it like a bright future there.
Yeah, we are setting ourselves up for dub.
Looks like Pandion there. Sets up that ward. Put a ping there, telling everyone that ward is right there. Looks like Mason flashes into the drag pit. I mean, they could see some turns. Looks like Pandion just dies. Hey, that's a Connor gets that. Hello.
Connor. Seems like we won that team fight.
Yeah.
This
our bot lane. Our bot lane staying sturdy. Guarding drag.
Fire dragon. That'd be really good for us.
Yeah. I mean, really, any Drake. Real good for our team. Let's see. Looks like they're deciding to leave Drake alone. Swain's recalling. So bot lane's recalling. It looks like Connor up top. I mean, definitely could.
That big dub that he's
had. Yeah.
Got a long gold.
Mason doing his thing in mid. Looks like Connor tried to put a bit of vision in the announcer bit. Going after his camps. Looks like mid lane is getting a little crowded here. Singe, the Swain, and the Jin all coming down mid. Looks like our jungle is getting a bit close there. Pantheon is a little closer to the dragon pit. It seems to me that blue team's really trying to be a little more wary of that dragon pit. It looks like a little
more
there. No, in the bush.
We have our fog of war on, so we can only see our things.
Yeah.
I would say they have a ward, but we can't see their ward placements.
We decide to pass by Drake again. Going down mid. Jason ignited and dying. We got that kill before that. That was pretty solid, yeah. Also, props to that game. He really turned around there. I think the turret's about to go down before the raid's coming in. Yeah, bot lane on mid. Looks like Connor here is getting the fire dragon. Bot lane back to the pit. Maddox seems like he had a feeling it was there, pulled one of his summoner spells over there.
Update from the story, my soup is incoming, so I should be able to eat now.
Nice. So and happy for you, Corbin.
The reason I'm talking much today, I'm a little hungry.
A little tired, a little sore. That's really interesting. I don't work out, so maybe that's tips for anyone watching.
You know how
I see. Looks like Swain picked off by the game tank. Looks like Harold is being solo picked off by Connor here. Diego. I mean, I guess it's not solo. He has his little chameleon, huh?
Little chameleon put in work.
Ooh, Jin being chased down by that top laner. Dang. Really went after it.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
Mid lane Mason getting some kill or some farming on minions down. Let's see. We got our jungler up top. It looks like a lot of there's the running down. Oh, he tries to go in, tries to make the most of it, and he gets that kill! A real pull through from Mason.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Seems that Mason is back mid lane, rail pushed back. Swain getting some vision behind the dragon pit. Looks like that Swain is recalling. Jin stayed in mid. Oh, until his recall was abruptly cut down by the crates. Mason on bot by himself against a Pantheon and Callista. It's very interesting. Our mid goes bot, our bot goes mid. But the enemy rolls stay the same. It's real interesting. I am not seeing a lot of the enemy team much this round. It's a lot of war. Looks like they're just trying to defend that turret right now. Mason camping out on that. Tribush getting rid of those wards. There's a gangplank. Old friend, oh buddy, old pal. Triple kill from that Olaf, and quadra kill from Diego. Good job, Connor. Nice. Green Drake. Let's see, Cloud Dragon. Plus 7% out of combat move speed, 7% slow resist. Connor Dexter and Zane behind the bottom. Connor evading with his kit. Zane and Dexter going back up mid. Maddox deciding to go on his own path. Clearing up some mini waves down here. Looks like, let's see. Jin is getting a bit of points for the camp. Back up top. Let's see what that runner is doing. Interesting. I believe that was Mason being bottom. Looks like it's another bot lane versus Mason. With the grades of 1v3. Mid, and Olaf defending their mid lane. Jin goes back. It looks like this is setting up to be a 4v1. That game kind of is in the center of the wall. Oh, he goes. Jin goes down. Olaf, so does Diego. Malphite gets that game crate. It looks like Mason is currently running off. But here comes Zane in this utility. Going after that that Callista. Real nice triple kill from Malphite. Zane our top laner. Good job, Zane. Looks like he's going after Red Buff? Clearing up that ward. Nice. He pinged that, warning people that bush is warded. Yeah, Maddox and Zane going after this invader. Looks like Connor and looks like Jin. Dexter's making his way back down mid. Connor going a different route. Swain and Malphite are making their way back up from the edge of their base. Looks like Callista. Callista and Pantheon trying to. I think they're going after Baron Asher. Dexter and looks like he's attempting to go near Baron Asher. But they can go to Freakers. Malphite seems to be making his way back to top lane, trying to defend the turret. Jin and or Dexter and Mason. Mason's making his way back mid. Looks like Dexter's going a little further bot lane. Ooh, that was a vision. That was a vision wave. My guesses are that one of the bot went down there close to it. Kara going after blue buff up here, getting blue buff. Love it. I really do love that bet. Swain and Vin reuniting. Welcome back! Did you get your soup? Oh, really? I don't know. That's why I had to be Mason goes down by Graves. Looks like we have, Jin and Diego still left.
Smile.
Double kill from Connor. Connor, see, Corbin just went. Some soup.
Yeah, I was very hungry.
Energized. Connor really held his own. He is doing real good. He got ace for our team. He's looking really good. Yeah.
I love him. So. I just lost contact with this pod that going straight up watching him win the game. Sorry to spoil the stream for all our watchers, but they were actively getting the dub. So this game has lost
my mind. While we're here, though, looks like Connor got that drag. See, Swain on a solo mission. Looks like he's trying to regroup with the rest of the team. Yeah.
We have a lot of movement speed right now.
Yeah, we sure do. 14%. Looks like everyone has their mythics. Nah, I know Jin has his mythic too.
They all have boots.
Everyone has boots.
Everyone has huge fast movement speed.
Yeah. That was real interesting. Jin, you got top lane. Looks like Diego and Jin regrouping. Gangplank down by Maddox. Swain, looking good. Pulls that stopwatch. Gray's back, looks like Jin tries to pull Gray's over. Real nice. Using his ult to try to pull out that Graves. Diogo making his way. Mason's a little hurt. A quarter of a bar for Mason. I need to be a full agent for.
Mace is an absolute monster.
He's a unit. He is a unit. Incredibly skilled. This looks like Mirren is in the game. Going back to my turn again. Shuts down the game.
Shut down.
Shutting down our Jin. Swain and Malphite retreating back, seeming to be the only ones left still up from that team fight. Both recalling.
Who's left on their team?
All of them are, except for Gangplank.
Oh, so we lost that team fight?
Okay, I mean, never want to give that Peto away.
I was wondering if they're still. No, they aren't playing anymore.
They're not. Playing out some minion over here from the blue team. Not quite, not mid. sorry. Swain getting that gangplank kill. Oh, isn't that amazing? Even as Malphite sits in that ult, it's still not even a chunk of his damage on him. Really trying to pull his own, being the only person left on that team. It looks like Seagate just won the second round, looking for a victory. Good job, Gabe, for telling everyone that.
The chase and the hunt, and I set the